So, a night where it'd be facing Monday Night Football, the first time in 2014, we have the quote-unquote season premiere episode of Monday Night Raw. Yeah! I don't know what's more uglier, this episode or the fact that the Detroit Lions kicked frickin' the New York Giants' ass on Monday Night Football, which is hilarious. But oh my word, that was bad. That was... But anyways, let's kick off the show with a steel cage match between Chris Jericho, baby, and Bray Wyatt. And what seems like to be the final match of their feud, thank God. And it's funny, you're finally ending this feud 2 weeks before your United Champions pay-per-view. Okay then. So, Chris Jericho vs. Bray Wyatt, very good match to start off the night. And overall, a pretty good river match. I mean, just, you know, back and forth action. At one point, Chris Jericho looked like he had this match won. Of course, he had Eric Rowan and Luke Harper behind the steel cage, you know, behind, around the ring. And it looked like Chris Jericho was going to win the match. He climbed up the cage, you know, the year. And, but no, Chris Jericho jumps off in midair, off the cage, and lands on Bray Wyatt for a huge crossbody drop. Very, very good, you know, move, highlight there, just to take a good spot. And, you know, Bray Wyatt was really focusing on the knee, you know, the knee injury that Jericho was selling. Jericho did a pretty good job selling the injury, by the way. And, you know, he's trying to climb out of the cage. Bray kind of hits on him a little bit and just rolls out of the cage. And, you know, ding, 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 you know, Bray Wyatt wins. And, you know, it seems like, okay, well, maybe that's the end. Maybe that's the end of, you know, so, you know, Chris Jericho. And Chris Jericho, you know, has all Fozzy tours coming up. So this will take a little break or so. And even after the match, you know, Wyatt wasn't done. He hit him with the Sisters Abigail inside the ring. So. Then afterwards, you have this little segment between, you know, Dolph Ziggler comes out saying that he has leaked photos on The Miz's phone. And we're all like, oh my god, this was supposed to be funny, and this was not funny or hysterical by any means. I like Dolph, I like Miz, you know. Yeah, I understand at least WWE's trying to put some time in this, you know, IC title feud, but still, it's like, oh my god. You come from last week where you had, was it last week or the week before? I think it was last week when you had the whole, you know, stunt double thing for The Miz. I thought that was kind of cool, you know, Damian Sandow down being stunt double. That was kind of a cool thing. But, you know, here it was just like, WWE tried so hard to be funny. And this is why I hate about WWE. You know, you can have your comedy segments. That's fine. I understand that. It's an entertainment industry. You know, you want to have your serious moments, you want to have your funny moments, you want to have your touchy moments, I understand that. But this is when WWE tries so hard to be funny, it's just, like, not funny. You know when, you know, that one kid tries so hard to be funny, and you're just sitting there blinking nonstop? That's the WWE sometimes, so. Just speaking of funny, I'll get to that later. But, yeah, this segment overall was just, I mean, I guess obviously you're trying to build the feud here, but it's just, oh my god, Miz Sandow came out and, So then you have this random Diva tag team match, AJ Lee and Paige. I think that's bad, it's not random. Obviously, you build them AJ and Paige. You know, Nikki in the match, we'll get to that later. AJ and Paige versus Rosa Mendez, who apparently, thanks to Total Divas, Mad Natalia is apparently babysitting Rosa Mendez. Eddie Cross. Oh, God. So this match lasted like a minute. You know, I guess the only highlight of this match, I guess, is when AJ literally slapped Paige's tit and then came in the match at the widow's peak. Rosa tapped out so fast, you didn't know what century she was. And so, yeah. And then at the end, it was just, this was, again, WWE needs to stop with this whole PG crazy lesbian angle. Like, if you're going to make them crazy-ass lesbians, at least step it up a notch or two. Maybe a kiss on the cheek. Corner of the lip, something. Like, enough. This is enough with the eating the candy, the freaking kiss. Now they're kissing the Diva title. What the hell is this crap? Like, seriously. And I know people are like, all the Divas are getting time. But these storylines are so crap. Does it even matter that they're getting time? Oh, they're still getting time. Yeah, horrible time. Like, oh my god. Seriously. And then you have this random backstage segment where Chris Jericho's getting, you know, getting the trainer to look at his knee, and Orton comes out of here for freaking nowhere, for no reason, attacks him, and he's like, sorry, Chris, what can I say? This is the season premiere. And he just walks out. It's like, what the fuck? You're really going to have this random Orton filler, Orton versus... versus Chris Jericho at Night of Champions because of a filler match, and you want to put Chris Jericho aside so you can do Bade Bebe. It'll be good. The match will probably be good. I'm not complaining whatsoever. I'm just saying that it's random as hell. Then you have Paul Heyman coming out, being Paul Heyman, you know, coming out saying that, you know, he believes in John Cena, but, you know, Brock Lesnar doesn't think he has it in him. And comes to save the day, of course. And, you know, basically, Paul Heyman's trying to do his best Kane impression from 2 years ago, saying that he needs to embrace the hate, that whatever someone says Cena sucks, you tell them to shut up. And then Cena's all telling Heyman to shut up, and saying that he's coming for Brock Lesnar, and then can't wait for their main suplex of the Night of Champions. Let me tell you something, guys. Woo! So you have Sheamus versus Seth Rollins, aka Celtic Warrior fella and the long lost X-Men, having their little match. Okay match, not too bad. Sheamus botched the living hell out of that freaking, trying to resell in that freaking curb stomp. I mean, no, sorry, trying to distract him with his freaking pepperoni looking nipples, but good lord, man. And Cesaro, God almighty, you need a new theme song. That ambulance is getting real annoying. It's not like getting your heel, but no, you can get a lot better theme song than that, trust me. Good boy. So then you have singing about the national anthem, Star Spangled Banner singing their own version of it, and saying how it's near the Russian national anthem, and yada yada yada. And I'm just like, okay, the only good thing as usual is seeing Lana. Rusev, shit. Anyways, next, move on. So this was actually probably the best part of the night. And I know I'm going to sound like a mark saying this, or, you know, an internet wrestling fan. But, you know, you had the NXT guys come out. You had Tyson Kidd, Tyler Breeze, gorgeous. You know, Adrian Neville, the NXT World Champion, and Sami Zayn, a.k.a. El Generico. And, you know, in a tag team match. And the match itself was actually pretty good. And it was just kind of cool in general what they did here. I mean, you had the lights turn, you know, yellow. And then you had the NXT, like, on the Minitron and the Titantron and what. It was like, they actually had some effort to make the guys feel like they were performing at NXT. Not on Monday Night Raw, on NXT. And, you know, other than being a big arena, obviously, it's not a full-scale university. But it was actually kind of cool, and I think a lot of people were impressed. A lot of the fans that don't have the WWE Network, and they don't, you know, watch, you know, Adrian Neville, Tyler Breeze, Sami Zayn, and even Tyson Kidd. I wonder, what the hell happened to Tyson Kidd? I just see him on Total Divas. I think a lot of people were impressed with, you know, Adrian Neville's Red Arrow. I mean, they're all like, whoa! You know, they did a pretty good job. So, overall, not bad trying to sell over your NXT TakeOver pay-per-view. You know, just see a special event on the WWE Network playing 9.99 this Thursday, guys. Woo. And then we have, oh my god, this was so stupid, so much of a cluster, so pointless, and yet so funny at the same time. Like, it was so bad. You ever watch something that's so bad? It's funny, and it's not supposed to be funny, but it's funny. This is a perfect example. This whole Jerry Springer intervention, where, you know, Stephanie McMahon, Queen of Queens, you know, she came out, and of course she looked like the greatest MILF of all time. But she came out there to introduce Jerry Springer. Jerry's like, hey, I'm back on here. And then out you comes, you know, Wonder Woman, Big Titty Bella herself. Then, of course, you have Wonder Woman, you know, Hippie Bella, you have her twin sister, Hippie Bella, who I didn't even know she had a new theme song. Apparently, she does. And, this was just, oh my god. Like, like, they shook hands, and, you know, steam everything hunky-dory, and then Jerry's all like, well, guess what? You guys apologized to each other on Twitter, yada, 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 and then Nikki out of nowhere mentions about how their, you know, parents split up because it's Bree's fault, and blah, blah, blah. And then they have, like, these little, like, small video packages that last, like, 5 seconds, like, tout, back in the judgment with tout. And I'll have the father and the mother all like, oh, I wish you two would just get along, we love you both the same, blah, 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 please stop fighting, yada, yada. And out comes JJ, yes, the little brother of Bree and Nikki come out. And I'm like, oh my god, this is, ugh, oh my god. And she's all like, and he's all like, oh, Bree's not the victim, there's someone the victim here, but it's not Bree, it's you, Nikki. She's like, really? She slapped JJ in the face, and they started cat fighting all over Jerry Springer. Jerry Springer had to get on a stretcher, and it was just so fucking bad. Oh my god. This was horrible, hysterical, pointless, a cluster, stupid. Alright, this was just, oh my god. I knew this was gonna be bad, but I had a feeling they were gonna bring their parents into this, but not JJ, really. The guy that said that Nikki was like the devil for having a quote unquote, you know, marriage. She was 18 years old on Total Divas. And, moving on. Stardust and Goldust versus Las Matadoras. Of course, Goldust and Stardust, you know, Brother Dust, as I like to call them, being the living hell out of people, win the match. You know, perfect way to make them look good for the Usos at Night of Champions for the tag battle, so, yeah. And then you have your little tribute video for Joan Rivers. I thought that was kind of nice, because Joan Rivers obviously passed away. I believe it was on Thursday or Friday? I think it was Friday. It was late last week that Joan Rivers passed away. Joan Rivers, famous comedian. She was rather funny. Rest in peace to her. Again, we move on to Adam Rose versus Titus O'Neil. All I gotta say is, Rosita Diatrinidad. You make our Boricuas look great. Oh my god. Come to bed with me. This match was, comedy match, LOL. Move on. So then we have, of course, your quote-unquote main event. Versus your rematch from SummerSlam. And I can't believe I'm saying this. I actually cared so much more about the SummerSlam match than this one. Because this match sucked. I'm sorry. I mean, I know you're boosting Roman Reigns. Your robotic freaking future face of the company. He looks like a goddamn gorilla these days. To the main event, and it's just like, what the hell? Like, Randy Orton tried so hard to make him look good, and tried so hard to pull in a match with him, and we all know, you know, Randy Orton really tries, the match ends up pretty good. And I'm not saying he didn't try, because it looked like he absolutely tried. This is Roman Reigns, and it's freaking four moves of, oh, punch, oh, spear, oh, Samoan drop, oh, shit. God. Like, seriously, what the hell? And then, you know, you had all of a sudden the cage starting coming down. Kane and Seth Rollins. Seth Rollins almost had a near-death experience. I'm not even joking I'm saying that, because he was all like, I can't get out. Like, I was scared there for a second. Oh my god, Seth Rollins almost died. That's, god, man. Tyler Black, chill out, man. And then comes with the steel chair, they beat the holy hell out of the authority, beats the living hell out of Roman Reigns. We're supposed to feel bad for Roman Reigns. I don't feel bad for Roman Reigns. I don't care for it. So we all know we're all going to have Seth Rollins and Roman Reigns at Night of Champions. Nothing, but, you know. This Monday night episode. Not good for a season premiere. Quote-unquote season. What in the hell is a season premiere for a weekly episodic episode for a freaking wrestling company? I never even heard. I know, it's WWE trying to be fancy. Don't try to correct me. It's just, oh my god. Anyways, that's it for me. Hope you guys enjoyed the review. I'm going to go back watching my night football. Peace, guys.